sir. Sir. Everything all right, sir?
Yes, fine. I'm just preoccupied, that's all.
Don't forget your invitation. Master Birch will be meeting you inside.
Thank you.
Where shall I retrieve you once you're done?
Front of the Opera House. And be quick about it. Don't expect to be here long.
I'll bring her round at once.
Invitation, please. Shall I take your coat, sir?
Ladies and gentlemen, you are requested to kindly find your seats.
Good evening, sir. This way, please.
My apologies.
Evening, Haytham.
Reginald?
I can't tell you how happy I was to hear they'd mounted this revival. Gay's best work by far. Have you seen it before?
Once. My father brought me here as a child, though I remember little of it. I don't suppose tonight will afford me the luxury of a proper viewing either.
No, I'm afraid it won't. On to business, then. Do you see him?
Be seated in one of the boxes above.
The stairs are watched. You'll need to find another way up.
So is mine. I already have. Double capacity, both against rote and form. For 'tis but fitting that we should protect and encourage cheats, since we live by them.
Sir, Black Maul, that set word of trial, comes on in the afternoon, and she hopes you will order.
A thousand pardons. My apologies. She's very active and
industrious. You may satisfy her that I'll soften the evidence.
Tom Gag, sir, is found guilty.
No lazy dog. When I took him the time before, I told him what would come to if he did not mend his hand. This is death without reprieve. I may mention a booking. For Tom Gag, £40. Let Betty Sly know I'll save her from the transportation, so I can get more by her staying in.
Betty has brought more goods into our locked ear than any driver of the gang. And in truth, it's a pity to lose so good a customer.
If none of the gang take her on, she may, in the common course of business, leave her 12 months longer. I love to let women escape. A good sportsman always lets the end barbed his fly, because the breed of the gang depends on it. Besides, here the law allows us no reward. There's nothing to be got by the death of women. Except our wives.
Without dispute, she is a fine woman. 'Twas to her I was obliged for my education. And to say a bold word, she hath trained up more young fellows to the business than the gaming table.
Truly, Filch, thy observation is right. We and the surgeons are more beholden to women than all the professions besides.
Sir, Black Maul, that sick word of trial, comes on in the afternoon. And she hopes you will order matters so as to bring off.
As the wench is very active and industrious, Do they satisfy that I'll soften the evidence?
Pom Gag, sir, is found guilty.
No lazy dog. When I took him the time before.
Tis woman that seduces all mankind. I know we must retort our evening arts. Her very lies can cheat when those she's mine. She tricks us of our money with our hearts. Tis woman that seduces all mankind. I know we must retort our evening arts. Her very lies can cheat when those she's mine. She tricks us of our money with our hearts.
I've got a bit of stage fright.
Well, don't you care a jump of the bloom in your cheek?
I make haste to Newgate, boy. And let me friends know what I intend. Well, I love to make them easy one way.
Penitence may break his spirit.
Jeremy's really burning up the boards tonight.
Certainly gives a man a bear upon his trial and makes him risk another without fear or scruple. But all the way, for 'tis a pleasure to be the messenger of comfort to friends in affliction.
But 'tis now high time to look about me for a decent execution against next sessions.
Haytham, you should have come to me. We would have found another way.
Yes, but then you would have known. For what it's worth, I'm sorry.
As am I.
Anyone suspicious coming from that room?
Peace, friends, there is no danger!
We can't search.
I can't get out.
Try to remember.
We must have order! Order! We must have order!
It happened right
in that
balcony.
We must leave at once.
What are those men doing?
There's a killer about. I'm staying where it's safe.
Down there.
Very well. Find anyone, give a shout.
And how was the opera?
Rather dull, truth be told.
Shall we be off, then?
Aye. To Fleet and Bride.
By your command.
Fascinating. Gentlemen, I hold in my hand a key, and if this book is to be believed, it will open the doors of a storehouse built by those who came before.
Ah, yes. Those who ruled, reigned, and vanished from the world. Do we know what it is that will be held within?
It could contain certain knowledge, perhaps a weapon, or something as yet unknown, unfathomable in its construction and purpose. It could be any of these things, or none of them. They are still an enigma, these precursors. But of one thing I am certain. Whatever waits behind those doors shall prove a great boon to us all.
Or our enemies, should they find it first.
They won't. You've seen to that.
I assume you know where this storehouse is?
Ah, Mr. Harrison.
Gentlemen.
How fair your calculations?
I believe the site lies somewhere within this region.
That's a lot of ground to cover.
My apologies. Were that I could be more accurate.
That's all right. It suffices for a start. And that is why we've called you here, Master Kenway. We'd like for you to travel to America, locate the storehouse, and take possession of its contents.
I'm yours to command, although a job of this magnitude will require more than just myself.
Of course. Upon this paper are the names of 5 men sympathetic to our cause. Each is also uniquely suited to aid you in your endeavor. With them at your side, you will want for nothing.
Well, then I'd best be on my way.
I knew our faith in you was not misplaced. We've booked you passage to Boston. Your ship leaves at dawn. Go forth, Haytham, and bring honor to us all.